Thank you, Grace. And can you confirm that you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you, Jay.
Okay. I am going to put a link into our portal, and I'm going to walk through this pretty quickly. It'll be thorough, but it'll be a little quickly just to see if I can get you over to the questions towards the end of or at the end of this training today. So firstly, that link that I put inside of the chat is the link that takes you straight to this page. It is the same link that we use for all of our functions within inside SSBCI, meaning the applications, reporting, and disbursements. We have a second URL that we have out there for users, and the URL that we have right now ends with an S. And you'll see once I dismiss this and I click the SSBCI program, you will see the suffix change to SSBCI homepage. So if you had that homepage URL, it is the same URL and it gets you to the same area. First thing you do is click over to the capital program reports. It defaults to your quarterly reports, so you will have to select the annual reports tab. Once you have the annual report tab, you will have a list of your annual reports. And for this one or this annual report, you will have a not started status, and then you will have your reporting period with your submission window. You click on the light blue pencil icon and that jumps you into the report. And it looks very similar to your quarterly reports where we have a navigation on the left-hand side. And then we also have a widget on the right-hand side that stays sticky throughout the different sections that you navigate through. Inside of the widget, you'll notice that you have your jurisdiction name. I'm in my test environment, so some things may look a little different in terms of the information that is here. But you'll have your jurisdiction name, you'll have the reporting period. This is the correct reporting period, January 1 through December 31. And then you'll have the deadline. For this reporting period, the deadline is going to be March 31. And as Sue mentioned, it will be open on Monday, April 1, for you to continue or submit, being that March 31 falls on a Sunday. Navigating through, you can click through your different sections on the left-hand side. Or at the bottom of each page, you have a back and a next button where you can go back to the previous section. So we'll start at section one, and this is going to be our user instructions. And again, it's going to first thing you're going to see in red is going to be your reporting period. And then you're going to see your submission window. We have some instructions and we have some blue text for you to click through with the reporting guidance here and the capital policy guidelines here, and then their user guide here. And we also have the SSBCI underscore information at treasury.gov email if you have any questions or problems throughout submitting your annual report. We do ask that if you do send an information or a question through the inbox, just kindly include your outreach manager. You have our privacy statement, and in the next section, section two is going to be the participating jurisdiction information. And this is going to be the implementing entity information that is pulled from your capital application. And we just ask that you verify to make sure everything is correct. And if things don't look right to you, again, reach out to us at the information inbox and include your outreach manager. We have a contacts area right here, and this will show all of the users on your account. If you need to add a user, we have a link right here that you can click onto. It takes us over to our COVID Relief Hub where you can add new users. When you're ready to add new users, first thing you're going to have to do is you're going to have to certify that you are the person that's able to add, and then you come to the designation form where you're able to add the new users. You can edit current users, or you can click and add a new user. Again, we're in my testing environment, so it's not going to add, but simply click on the blue button, add a new contact, and you add all of the asterisk items that you need to add. First name, last name, title, name of organization, and you can select a role here. As Sue mentioned, we have three different roles that are appropriate for you guys. First one is going to be the admin or account admin role. And this is the person, once you give them that role, they can view and download the quarterly report. Oh, I'm sorry, the annual report. We had the account POC, and everything has a capital as a prefix. The account POC, they can view, download, and upload the completed annual report. And then we have the SSBCI Capital Authorized Representative. And this is the one that can view, download, upload, and submit the annual report. Once you have all your selections and your entries, you would click Add New Report or New Contact, and that person will be added to this table here. And you can close out that tab because that person will be added to your users or in your contacts on this page here. We'll move over to section 3 is where you can just take a look at all the information here. Again, we have another link for the reporting guidance. And then we have your template to be able to be downloaded here. And as Sue mentioned, that template will be ready on February 6th. Once you have downloaded your template and you've uploaded all the information that Grace has just went through, you click on Upload Files. You find your template, click OK, and then you get an Upload Files dialog, a blue Done. Once you hit Done, it's going to populate a table right here. Sue also mentioned that if you have no reportable transactions for the year, that you would simply click this button right here. Since I've already added this, I am not able to click this. But if I do have it and I have no reportable transactions, you can click that button here. And that indicates to us that you have no reportable transactions for the year. You may have noticed that this record still stayed here. The thing I like to do always is just refresh the page. And then when we refresh, you see that that item will have been removed. And that was in section 3. And you see that that has been removed. One thing to note, if you select this box here on section 4, this will be grayed out. Again, we're in my testing environments and the developers are going through to make sure that this is grayed out for you if you make the selection here indicating that you have no reportable transactions. I'm going to re-upload that file so we can move to the next section. And that is for your annual report narrative. On an annual report narrative, this is a required area. And you would upload your annual report narrative here. We give some descriptions of what we expect in the narrative. And then once you have all of this satisfied and you have it in a Word format, you would upload that here. Once it is done, click yes, and you'll see a table populated with the narrative. Moving on to section 5 is the submission of certification page. And the thing I like to say about this page is when you go to certify, I advise just copy your name that you see here because this box here is case and space sensitive, meaning if I change that to a lowercase s and hit certify and submit, I'm going to get an error. So it's just as simple as copying your name here, dropping into the box here, and you can hit certify and submit. Sue also mentioned that while we're inside of our reporting window and a deadline has not reached, you can always unsubmit your report if you realize that you have something that you missed or you want to update either your annual report or your narrative. I know I went through that pretty quickly. It's pretty simple, but if you do have any questions or issues during your submission, please reach out to us at the SSBCI underscore information at treasurer.gov and include your outreach manager. With that, I will move it back over to Sue. Thank you.
Thank you, Jay.